In this After Effects tutorial, I'll show you how to create a fake 3D page flip transition. Hey everyone, my name is Manuel. And let's dive right in. First of all, we create a new comp. HD resolution, 3 seconds long. Let's name it page 1. For a page flip animation, we need a page first of all. We add a new solid, Command or Control Y. Name it paper. Color white. Then let's add some text. We grab the title tool, click into the comp window and create a text box, covering the left half of the screen. Let's adjust its shape a little bit. Then we need to add some text. I asked ChatGPT to write me some random text. Thanks very much, that's awesome. I copied the first part into the text box, adjusted the text settings to get one of the two columns. Now I need to duplicate the text layer and move the text box to the right half of the comp. Replace the text with the second part. Awesome! Let's grab the comp in the comp window and add it to a new comp. We name the new comp Page Flip Animation. This is our main comp. We use the white solid from before again in the solids folder. And use it as paper background again. Then let's animate the page. First of all, we choose the anchor point tool and move the anchor point to the center of the right edge. Hold Command or Control to let it snap into place. Then we turn it into a 3D layer. Let's open the rotation property, press R, and animate the Y rotation. 0 at the beginning, we set a keyframe. Then we go to 1 second and set the rotation to minus 70 degrees. Let's adjust the endpoint of the comp. We move it to 1 second. We select both keyframes, open the graph editor to adjust the speed graph. Make sure snap is activated. Then we slow down the beginning of the animation, dragging the point to the zero line, the handle to the right. We slow down the end slightly. Let's check it out. Alright, not really convincing. We'll get there. Next, we use the Effects and Presets window to add an effect. CC Page Turn. We search for it and add it. We set controls to bottom left corner and set the fold position to the bottom left corner. 0 and 1080 pixels. We set fold radius to 300. The light direction to around 220 degrees. We want to render the front and back page. And we set the back opacity to 100. Then let's animate the fold position property. We add a keyframe at the beginning, press U to see the keyframes in the timeline. At 12 frames, we move it to around 700 and 650 pixels. At 18 frames to around 1350 and 675 pixels. Alright, that's better. Before we move on, I wanted to let you know that I created my first course. Learn how to create complex animations with expressions in After Effects. In this course, we start from zero. From basic expressions to responsive animations, dynamic text animations, and repetitive techniques. You'll have a whole set of new tools which will make you faster, better, and stand out from the crowd. Reasons enough to check out the course. Link is in the description. Awesome, back to the transition. We need a back page, so let's duplicate the page 1 comp and name it back page. We add it to the bottom of the layer stacking order and you can hide it as well. Then we select the page 1 comp and select back page in the drop-down menu. And the text is mirrored. We go back into the back page comp, select the first text layer and add an animation preset, which is called flop. We search for it in the effects and presets window. We add it to both text layers. This should do the trick. Then we select the paper solid and add a gradient ramp. Set the white end of ramp beyond the left edge. The black start of ramp somewhere towards the center. Let's move the start even further left. To simulate shade, let's go back into the main comp. Much better. We need to add some shade here on the left though. Therefore, we select the page 1 comp again and add a drop shadow. Set the distance to 50. The softness to 200. The direction to around 220 degrees. We go to 12 frames in the timeline and set keyframes for the distance and softness. Then we duplicate the effect. Set the opacity to 85%. Distance to 30. Softness to 100. I always use this effect twice because it looks much more natural. Let's press U again to see all keyframes. Then we go to 1 second and animate these 4 properties. We set distance 1 to around 170, softness to 420, distance 2 to 220, softness to 480. Awesome! You should play around with the speed of the animation in the settings to figure out what feels right for you. Let's add some more pages. I simply duplicate page 1 2 times. And offset the comps by 3 frames. You can add different content of course, create more pages and replace these pages here with the new pages. It seems to look great. Almost. It's all just fake 3D, so the corners of the second and third page are behind each other, although they should be on top of each other. To solve that, we duplicate the main comp. Rename it. Back page 2. Go into it and solo the second page. Set the render in the CC page turn effect to back page. We go back into the main comp and add it to the top. That looks much better. Let's add the back page of the third comp as well. We duplicate the back page 2 comp. Open it and solo page 3. Set the render in the CC page turn effect to back page. We go back into the main comp and add it to the top again. That's how I would create an almost realistic page flip transition. Replace the paper solid with the footage you want to reveal. Add the content you want to hide to the first page on top. Make sure to check out my course, Expressions are a powerful tool in After Effects. On the left side, I've added a video you might like. Thanks for watching this one. See you in the next one. Bye everyone!